mind for rising, falling, then based on the movements, becomes weak. Meditators do not perceive it clearly. Then meditators, they mind for sitting postures and two points of touching again. So these three objects are known as the primary objects or the basic object of sitting meditation. Whenever meditators mindful of any of these primary objects, then there's more distinct object rising. For example, meditators begin to feel numb on the legs. If the numbness becomes stronger and stronger, then meditators may find difficult to find who and know the primary object or the sitting postures. It's because now the numbness becomes more distinct or more dominant than primary objects. Then meditators should be mindful of numbness. It's because a principle of the Vipassana meditation or the guideline of mindfulness meditation is to be mindful of the most dominant object. So when numbness becomes more dominant, clearer or stronger than the primary object, then meditators should be mindful of numbness and know if meditators feel painful, then look pain. Perceiving the painful sensation or the numbness as it really occurs. Then sometimes the meditators be mindful and look pain. Painful sensation may become stronger or the sensation is decreasing. Meditators need to be patient, especially when the sensation such as pain, numbness becomes stronger and stronger. But during sitting meditation, meditators need to develop patience, especially when meditators feel pain or any physical discomfort. Usually we advise meditators not to move or shift the sitting postures or change your sitting postures. For example, you may begin with full lotus postures, then you change to half lotus or three postures and so on. It's not advisable. It's because when meditators begin to change or move the legs in order to relieve the pain or any physical discomfort, then sooner or later it may become a habit in the practice. And this habit is not a good habit. It may become a hindrance to your progress in mindfulness, concentration, and insight knowledge. So patience is important. If the painful sensation or any physical discomfort becomes unbearable, then meditators may stand up and practice walking meditation again. But at the same time, meditators also need to develop another quality, that's the determination. If meditators do not have strong determination, then meditators may change their postures from sitting to walking as and when they like it, or they could not, as and when they like it, or in other words, sometimes meditators may sit about 20 minutes, then they feel some sort of discomfort, then they may stand up, practice walking again. So in that way, meditators may not be able to sit long, because if meditators did not develop patience and tolerance towards the pain. So you need to develop determinations so that you become more patient, tolerance, towards any painful sensation or physical discomfort. Then, sometimes as you're mindful of the primary objects or the body sensation, the mind may wander away, or any mental state could be arising at any moment. There are various kinds of mental state, for example, thinking, planning, wondering, or sometimes emotional mental state could be arising. For example, you will think about any incident, then anger arising, then you should be mindful of anger at all. Or sometimes you are thinking of an incident, causes a worry to arise, then you should be mindful of worry. Worry until disappear, then you only be mindful of primary objects again, or whatever object that is predominantly arising at that moment. So sometimes the mind may be thinking of something. As soon as you know that the mind is thinking of something, then you have to be mindful and no thinking. Until the thinking disappears by itself, then if there's no other distinct object, you may go back to the prime object again. For example, be mindful of movements and tokens, and know it as it is rising, falling. If the movements and tokens are not clear, then meditators be mindful of attentive, the sitting postures, and 2 points of touching. So during meditation, meditators have to develop mindfulness from movement to movement, or be mindful of one object or one phenomenon that is predominantly arising at that moment. So whatever object or phenomenon that you are mindful of, you also have to make a mental noting or labeling. So mental noting or labeling is not meditation, but help you to build mindfulness so that your mindfulness becomes more attentive, precise to whatever object that you are mindful of. So that's a sitting meditation. Before I proceed to explain further, I shall explain in brief in many ways.今天想先介绍我介绍这四念处毗婆舍那禅的修行，所以这是毗婆舍那禅，在巴黎文称为毗巴舍那巴瓦那，巴瓦那这个字的意就是培育。 或者说训练，或者说发展，毗婆舍那，是根据巴利文毗婆舍那音译，其实毗婆舍那就是指观自，透视到身心现象的真实本质的观自，或者说借助今生的体验。 正确了解身心现象的无常跟无我，所以这就是一种智慧，也是也称为内观，所以毗婆舍那禅，巴利文就是指毗婆舍那达摩那，也是可以称为观智的第一，观智的发展，所以当 我们要可以观自，透视到身心现象的真实本质，也就是无常、苦跟无我。那么修行者必须可以正念，观察在身和在心升起的每个现象，依照他真实的面貌，观察，所以在 毗婆舍那禅的修习，修行者所必须做的就是，一正念，一瞬间，即一瞬间的正念。所以只要我们并不是在修习，其实我们必定有正念，因为正念就是一种觉知，当你并不是在修习，一定有觉知的心，换句话说。 你心知道在身起的感受，或者在心升起的思维分析等等，但是如果一个人还没有经过任何禅的练习，没有练习禅的经验，或是没有训练心的经验， 他很可能不会真正的知道在当下，在身和心 as of